Hello friends, welcome to this video tutorial by Perfect Web Solutions. My name is Imran Qasim, and in today's video tutorial, basically this is a request from one of my followers that he watched a video of mine where I have shown you how you can convert a placeholder image to any other image. So what he wants, that he wants to change the product itself. Like, this is single product page, and from here normally it shows the thumbnail image, but I have replaced it with the video, and the client wants that as well. Not only that, he also wants that on the shop page where it shows the product thumbnails like this, it also shows a video thumbnail rather than these images. So I can show you that I have done that, and here these two are the videos which are both of them are from my channel. One is from Laravel 5 and one is from Woocommerce. That the same placeholder image setting, so just give it the time to load the thumbnail and you can see them here easily. I have done this using another plugin called ACF, Advanced Custom Field plugin, but you are free to use without using any other plugin as well. You can do it with custom fields, but as this ACF plugin is more powerful, so I'm using it here, but that doesn't mean you can't do it. I will show you both ways. First I will show you how you can do with the ACF, Advanced Custom Field. After that I will show you without using ACF, just simply using the custom fields option, which is a built-in feature inside WordPress. So let's get started. Let me open my text editor, and this is the functions.php file, and also I have loaded my active things functions.php file, as well as I have opened the WooCommerce plugin here as well. Here it is in the plugins folder. And in the WP admin dashboard, in the custom fields options, when you install Advanced Custom Field Lite plugin, don't need to go for Pro for this. You can use the Lite, which is free version on the GitHub, on the WordPress repository. So you can go to custom fields. In the custom fields, you can create a new field group. I have created this WooCommerce featured video. There are a few others I have created, but we have concerned with this WooCommerce featured video, and there is only one field with it. So let me show you, edit it, and here is the name of this feature field group, and then here is the field label. And the most important thing is that location tab and the rules, you need to set the rules. Post type, from here you select post type, and then is equal to product. Make sure you have selected that product, and then add this new field here. You can click, if there is no field by default here, you can click on add field, and it will show you a menu options like this. And here you type the title, here you type the name, type field type, and then this is the instructions. Default value, you can put a default image here, placeholder text, what you want to user say in the inside the place, inside the text box, and then you can use the rest of them, let them be default. After that, click on publish, and I have updated here because of I have already published it. So go to custom field, you will find this one here. So next, go to the products tab and edit any of your product. Let me do these two. I have done these two. So click on edit, or you can add new product as well. So here you will see a featured video. Go to YouTube and get the idea of this is the area. You can place this anywhere on your this product page, anywhere on the top, bottom, left, right. I have put it normally by default wherever it is. So I have put here YouTube video ID. You can get your YouTube video ID by editing or by watching any video, and it will show you the ID here at the end of the video list. Suppose if I play any video, it will show me that ID over here. You can copy that ID only and paste it here. That's it for the backend part. Now let's move to the coding part. For the coding part, open your favorite text editor. Mine is Sublime Text 3. You can use any of your choice. And here I have used two functions, basically one filter and two functions. The filter I used is WooCommerce single product image, and I wrapped it inside WooCommerce get product video if not function exists. That if this function does not exist, then this function will be created, otherwise this function will not work. So this is just a check. So this plugin add filter WooCommerce single product image thumbnail HTML. Make sure you spell it correct. This function, this is a filter inside WooCommerce which is responsible for displaying single page, this when you click on the page and here it shows the image, this is the single product image. I mean, this is the WooCommerce single product image thumbnail. So I have used this filter and I have created my own function. This function accepts one parameter which displays the default image. So I have assigned featured video variable that get field is this, get field is the function of ACF light. So I pass the field name and then get the ID function. This get the ID function will get the ID of current at open product or any post, because basically everything in WordPress is a post, whether it's a portfolio, gallery, product, whatever it is, it's a post. So you get it by this and it will save inside this the value of this featured video which you have given here. This one, this value is saved inside this featured video variable. Now I checked it. If this featured video is not empty, simply return the video with the iframe code. This is a standard embedding code of YouTube. You can use Vimeo, you can use other any video link you can use here. You can put it here. If I'm currently I'm using YouTube, so that is why I put here YouTube embedding code. And if it's empty, I mean there is no featured video, it will return the default image. As you can see, many of my other products, like if I open this product, Ship Your Idea, it won't show you that video. It is showing you default image because this particular product does not have a featured video added inside it. But as soon as I add it, it will be shown here. So I hope you get it how to use this filter option. So and display that product video on this single product page. So come to the next part where you need to display the video here. So after a search, recursive search, I found that this WooCommerce get product thumbnail is a function which displays the this WooCommerce get product thumbnail function is responsible for displaying these thumbnails, right? So what I did here, I just make a trick that in WooCommerce it also added wrapped inside this if not function exists. So I just copied it and then I pasted it, this function, whole function here, and make the necessary changes that I put the main code, which is this one, on the else, and in the normal if I put the same code. And here I get the featured video with featured video field name and the post ID. Here, because we have a global post variable, so I use that post ID so it can show you the post of current ID of the current post. And the rest is same, that if not empty frame featured video, return this iframe. So if there is no featured video, use else this property is equal to this. If I can show you, this function is included in WooCommerce folder, includes wc template functions.php file here. This function, I just copy this portion. If it also it have a check here, if not function exists. So when you create it, it means it is existing, so that WordPress, that WooCommerce won't create that function by itself. So it will use this function and it will convert any of your image thumbnail into video. So you can do more, like you can put a check inside using ACF field. You can put a check whether you want video or you want the default image. So it's up to your logic how you're going to use it. This is the way using ACF. The same way you can use custom fields, like if you go to screen options, and by default sometimes this custom field is not checked. So you click here, custom fields, and it will come here. And same thing, you can enter new. Here is featured video variable. This one is featured video. So I make it video featured. Just to show you the difference, and the value will be same like this one. I put the value here. So that's it. Add custom field, click. So now we have a custom field video featured and a featured video, two custom fields, right? We get this field using the get field option, but we will get this because this is default WordPress feature. So we will use get post meta function. Let me show you. I will update it and make sure this is product without featured image. This is product without featured image. This is the product which I'm editing right now here. So that we have both with same values. So now go to my code editor and I will go to product thumbnail, and where I said featured video is equal to this, I will comment it out. So rather than I will just put it so that it won't generate any error, I will just copy this and paste it here and equal to empty string. So now there is no featured video in it, and if I reload the page, you will see here no image, because this product don't have any image and this one have an image. So both remove that, both product doesn't have video right now. So let's come here. So now before we use get field, now we use get post meta. So it accept the post ID. So here we will put post ID, and then I will put here video featured, because I created this key value is video featured. So that is why I put here video features. You can copy it so that it doesn't make an, and this false make it true so that it will return its value to this feature. So save it, and now go here and reload the page, and you will see that this video will come back again. And why not? Is and you will see that it's not coming here, because in this particular product we didn't put any code for featured video. For featured video, this for post meta, but we did put it for ACF, but we didn't put for post meta. So that is why it is not showing video here. But as soon as I comment out this one and uncomment this one and save it and reload the page, and it will show video for both of them now. So friends, this concludes the tutorial. I'm sure you like this tutorial, and this tutorial specially dedicated to one of my followers who requested this video tutorial, that how can we change the product image to a product video. So I'm sure others who are watching this also like this video. So please thumbs up and click the like button, and do subscribe to my channel, and do make requests. If I can do that, I will surely do it for you, and I will put you as well on it, that this tutorial is specially for my follower. And if I can show you at the end, I can show you his comment, this one comment. I go to comment. I'm using TubeBuddy plugin, so it, and here you can see a nice tutorial, and here you can see here Olin N. Comedian Voice Off has requested nice how to replace product image by a video. So I have explained it though, but I mean I may not understand, so I told him that okay, I'll create a screencast for you. And my friend, here is a screencast for you. And thank you very much for liking my videos and subscribe to my channel. And you are subscribed, I'm sure you subscribe to my channel. Thank you very much once again, and take care. Bye.